During the summer months, we really are quite self-sufficient.
I feel as though I'm doing kind of my little bit.
Part of our role at Centrica is how do we solve the climate change problem for our society? A lot of people think emissions come out of power plants, but our biggest emissions are from our customers. The customers are at the heart of making a choice about energy in a way that they haven't had that choice before.
We're now the fourth generation that are working on the farm and running the business here. For us, it just comes naturally to look after the land and the environment that we've got around us. We've got our 250 kilowatt solar array, which generates all our electricity. We would generate all day, and most of our guests would be out. So most of our generation would be sold or put back onto the grid. But now with the red tier units, we're going to be able to store all of that generation. So it will be still available for the grid for people, businesses to use when we don't want it. But at other times when we have got more of a demand, we can then also utilize our own generation.
We have things like our local energy market program in Cornwall, where we're trying to figure out how we can enable more and more renewable energy to get put onto a local energy system. It's about energy being produced locally and then energy being consumed locally. We need to be flexible about how we consume our energy. That's where technology like blockchain comes into play. It's allowing people to trade or transact with each other in a really reliable and secure kind of way.
Just from the solar panels, we've reduced our figures by a quarter, I would say.
The battery app actually tells you all the consumption, how much you're generating from the solar panels, how much you're taking from the national grid, and how much the battery has charged. And so you can see how much money you're saving from reducing your grid purchase and even feeding into the grid.
Hive is allowing people to control their homes. It's using sensors and the Internet of Things to enable customers to have more control, more awareness of what's happening inside of their homes. The potential of that is enormous.
It helps you control your lighting and your heating all around the house, whatever you've got plugged in. That's quite handy when you're out and about. You can just check, oh, I've left the lights on or I've left the heating on, so you can just turn it off. Feeling a bit too warm, it's good. You can just turn it down a good degree or two.
See, can you hear that? No sound. It's silent. It's like sitting there with the engine off. We're about to drive down the most polluted road in the UK. I'm driving down there with a clear conscience. This is the van. Lovely van. The electric side is this side. It charges this battery. Then there's a main battery underneath the vehicle. That's where the energy goes and that's what drives the vehicle. Yeah, it makes me proud that our company is moving forward and going with electric and hybrid vehicles, lowering our carbon footprint.
People were pretty skeptical about whether electric vehicles would be a thing. We're growing the infrastructure very quickly so people will be able to charge. And over the last year, it's become abundantly clear that electric vehicles are on their way. We need to find out solutions that make people more comfortable, save them money, and reduce their carbon emissions, not either or.
We want to look after what we've got here for my children and the next generation to come on.
Everybody has their kind of footprint, so it's quite nice to know that I'm shrinking mine.
It's our responsibility to do that. Everyone's got to make a difference. We need to lead by example.
Yeah, I think it has to be possible. We have to figure out how our whole energy system can be clean. It's going to take a while, but we'll get there.